When does a hero's journey begin? The moment you step outside the safety of your homes? Or when you realize the fight has just begun? Is it when you comprehend how small you are compared to the vastness?
Not too long ago, a group of planeswalkers got together in the Blind Eternities and began to work on something. Something that they thought would change the way the world was. They thought that working together, they would be able to change things, to help one another, and share knowledge to benefit everyone. This group became known as the Magic the Gathering Content Creators Group. I've been a part of this group since it started, and was one of the first 10 to put my name in. And it has been a great source of knowledge. So much so that I must credit this next video to one of who I would have to say has helped me the most since Jeremy Hambly, and that is Warlord Hank.
What's up, people? It's John, also known on the internet as Warlord Hank, and we're doing a new thing right now.
The best part about this is that Hank doesn't know I'm doing this, and I find that very amusing because I think, or I hope, he'll enjoy this as much as I do. So, how does this play in? Well, Hank went one step further with the Content Creators Group, and he created a sub-1K playlist. Now, this playlist is basically all his favorite content creators, or from what I can gather, all the content creators that are under 1K, because he noticed that while everyone was, you know, doing the weekly MTGs, he thought he could help everyone else by spreading the word for everyone who could use an extra boost. And I would like to say that it's working. Now, what I mean by this is that while I've been keeping a close eye on my YouTube metrics and my Social Blade metrics, I clicked on something else today, a tab that I haven't normally checked, and it revealed this. It revealed my top video suggestions and basically my top viewed videos. And when I took that a step further, I noticed that almost 50% of my viewership is coming from his playlist. The reason this is important is because, well, as I stated, he's gone a step further. He's put in extra work for all the people. And it seems like the last 6 months has been nothing but stagnant growth for me. Doesn't matter what I do, what I try, who I talk to, it seems like the videos aren't being discovered. So the extra help is definitely boosting my self-esteem and my creative genius, or, well, genius is a very loose term in this sense, but my creativeness, which has led me to do this video. My first video of probably a small series of maybe 5 or 10 where I highlight the best of the best in the community. Now, I could have started with Jeremy Hambly because Jeremy and I go way back, and when I first started, he was the only one that would respond to me, but I'm gonna start here on a more neutral ground because Hank and I, while he does this, don't necessarily see eye to eye on some things, and that's what makes this even more better, because when you have a neutral party or someone who's willing to hear you out and, you know, stand his ground on what he believes in and what I believe in and not let that compromise the integrity he has, it says a lot about his character. So then, who is Warlord Hank? The question keeps coming up. Warlord Hank is an American streamer who got into Magic back in 1994. Like, you know, most of us, you know, friends, brother, they were super into D&D, and well, like most of us who enjoy the settings and the universe, most of us aren't really big on playing it, and neither was Hank. All that work for 5 minutes of playtime only to continuously roll ones leaves a sour taste in your mouth. But when his brother brought home Magic the Gathering, things would change. I guess you could say that, like the rest of the planeswalkers in this multiverse, he was all in. While he played off and on, he did take a 15-year break, and I can relate. I was on again, off again myself. It wasn't until he was going through all his old cards to try and sell to buy a Switch for his middle child that his oldest took an interest. So he did what any respectable parent would do. He taught him to play Magic the Gathering. And then after that, he took it one step further. He made videos with his son. Although he didn't originally start there. If you go far enough back into his videos, you'll find that he garnered over 20,000 views from Guild Wars 2. That's quite impressive for a game that's been out for a long period of time. And they still have momentum. And he still keeps everything very interesting by doing stuff that you don't normally see on YouTube, such as my favorite videos, the ones where he cleans Magic the Gathering cards. In the one I'm going to show you, he takes the markered border off of a underground sea, because who hasn't done that before? But if you go onto his videos, you can actually see him clean up a foil, an Academy Rector, if I remember correctly, with nothing more than a dry erase marker, some rubbing alcohol, and some paper towel. To me, that's quite impressive. So I'll leave it here with this. If Warlord Hank is willing to do this for people he doesn't know in a community he hasn't really participated in for this short amount of time, I'm willing to go out on a limb and say that, you know, he's one of the good ones, and I wish him the best in the future. He does know how I feel about the analytics and all the work he's done for me, which is why I've made this video, because I want to kind of return the favor. Maybe not now, but in the future when he gets famous, or when I, get more than 20 views. It'll be great. I think things will look up. I think what he's done with the lower content creators is fantastic. And there's a lot of people who can contribute to this. Like the MTG Strategist, I believe he was the one that started the group. And all the people who contribute to responding to questions for all the content creators. It's one of those things, right? It's a very immersive environment. And without helping one another, we may end up, you know, floundering or lagging behind. There's some channels with minimal growth, there's some channels with a lot of growth, and it's just the organic views. Sometimes you use the right tag at the right time, and it captures a bunch of people, or if you upload regularly. The analytics is such a funny thing that people claim to have all these answers, but when you try them, it's like it's ever-changing and ever-growing. It's one of those things that just, one of those beasts you just can't tame. You can try, and you may hit it for a while, which is why I think it's so crazy or so hard, it's always ever changing, that, you know, to try and capture a piece of that analytics is, you know, like one of the great unicorns. And it's with that I give Warlord Hank my praise, and you should too, especially on his 1K playlist. And with that, I bid you all a fond farewell, and see you soon. I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual, former Knight of the Roundtable, and member of the Phoenix Syndicate. Thank you for watching. If you liked this video and would like to see more like it, click the like button and subscribe. To be notified, don't forget the bell, because we all know YouTube won't do it. If you would like to support the cause further, you can donate at the links below. And I would like to thank the current supporters, because without you, this wouldn't be possible. And remember to support your local game store, as they are in the brick and mortar of the games community. I'm Jay the Filthy Casual, and thanks for stopping by.